Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Alright, we're spotting the dog. We're coming to the end of the line. We've caught the dog. We take one more step. Now look how I am and look how you are. No, you're coming to the end. There. Now you caught the dog. Open up. Now you're transitioning.
No. Redemption Road Canine is a cynology center located right outside of LA in the city of Santa Clarita. We specialize in, among other things, canine conditioning, fitness, nutrition, training. We do assist with some breeding programs that we've been brought in as partners, and a ton of research.
Keep coming, catch the dog, clear the junk. Very nice.
We are right now in Agua Dulce, which is an exurb of the city of Santa Clarita. We're at Redemption Road Canine Ranch. The ranch itself is a little over 10 acres, or 400,000 square feet. We have three training fields here. We have a barn that we've converted to military grade kennels, and we have an assortment of animals and livestock. The Coliseum, as we call it, and that's our protection field. There we have confidence cage, we have a targeting table, we have things that pertain to the sports that I practice and decoy in. So we got French ring, we got some Mondio ring, and then we have some PSA stuff.
A brevet is just a test of courage. You know, you can start getting in the upper levels of PSA and ring. They're opening things up at less than a meter. That one I opened up probably less than a meter. That was good. Good work, OG.
Cynologist is a dog scientist, someone who studies domestic canid species. And I met a cynologist from the UK who blew my mind. I didn't even know this was a job. And her entire job was to go around studying wild dogs in different locations and then drawing comparisons with domestic canids. So she'd been to India and Taiwan and Japan, a bunch of places to study the wild dogs, and I just thought that was fascinating. So I kept in contact with her, and she's kind of been guiding me on my efforts. And for us, what we do and what I do here, I study domestic canids and in particular canine learning theory, how to best teach a dog things that benefit mankind with the least amount of aversives and corrections, I guess you'd call them. At Redemption Road Canine, we believe that all dogs are working dogs. Because two of my first dogs were, I guess to some extent, rescues, I developed a passion. I started in the shelter world, working with troubled dogs, aggressive dogs, dogs that have been abandoned, abused dogs. So I found that to be fulfilling, and I found a certain kind of therapy within that work. So our approach here has been to offer both dogs and people a chance at a second chance at life, really. Being involved in the dog world as a trainer, as a researcher, as an educator, and as a certified decoy, I've got a chance to learn a lot about a lot of different breeds. And I have a pretty diverse group of dogs here. I have an Anatolian Shepherd, or Kangal, as they're known in Turkey, named Attilius of Anatolia.
Right now we're working on preparing him for some movie work. I want to really tighten up our distant sign language and his ability to place onto a platform or a hold marker, a place marker. Basically, I'm going to be using my hands at a close proximity and then proofing that, increasing the distance and duration over time. But right now, like, down, down, using marker training to mark when he does it. Attilius, sit. That's it.
Attilius is a really awesome dog. He's 2 years old. Attilius of Anatolia, our Kangal, does have double dew claws on all four. And I know that there's some debate about what to do with these. For me personally, I don't believe nature has very many inefficiencies, so I don't alter my dogs in any way. He's a very big boy. He has about 6 different titles. And he works primarily though in right now as a livestock guardian. I know there are people who disagree with that idea of livestock guardianship, but here on the ranch we have 10 acres and we have an assortment of livestock that needs protection against predation. Because I'm not an advocate of killing coyotes and killing wolves and foxes and things like that. My goal in introducing the Anatolian here on the ranch and in Southern California is to introduce a way to positively coexist with the wildlife that exists here. So my Anatolians are not trained in any way, shape, or form to go kill anything. They're trained to bark, alert, and deter predation against our livestock. Cerberus. Cerberus of Hades is a DDR, German Shepherd. He's a great dog. Very particular personality, but he loves me. He works hard for me. He's training in apprehension and in the sport of French ring. And he'll probably get some detection work done.
And this is more stuff for inside the house. I have my dogs inside the house. Go to your bed. Good, go to your bed. Go to your bed. Good. Now, we'll introduce kind of the next step of it. So, go to your bed. Down. Good.
Itai of Gath, or Goth, depending on where you're from. Itai is a Rottweiler with German bloodlines. Great dog. He's about 9 months old, and so far we've just been socializing him here, getting him used to life on the ranch, accustomed to working within the confines of a pack, and then really, really getting him used to being around animals that he can't engage because he's got some pretty substantial prey drive. Xerxes of Persis. She's our second Anatolian, a new addition to the pack. She is a brindle Anatolian Shepherd, and she's a dream. She's here to work alongside the Rottweiler Itai and Attilius in terms of protecting the property from predation.
All right, so this is a raw fur that I bought from a taxidermist. And with my Anatolians, I'm not particularly interested in them aggressing against man or anything like that. They're here to protect the livestock, protect the birds, you know, the guinea fowl, the ducks, the rabbits, and the horses and whatnot. So I start my my puppies pretty young, my livestock guardians, on what I want them to be alerting on. So this is just kind of a game to get her interested. Yeah, yes, girl. So I have clients from all walks of life, and on any given day, meet a celebrity actor, a professional athlete, a billionaire investor, a federal marshal, a former gang member, all at the same time. Because of that fact, because we have such a diverse clientele base, we are able to do some really interesting things. We've traveled to Dubai, South Korea, Japan, Vietnam, all under the auspices of dog training. And most recently, we took a trip to Van Nuys Private Airport, and we were able to board and hang out, fly around on a private jet. It was a G55 Gulfstream that belongs to a client, and we got to drive our cars onto the tarmac and bring our dogs. It was really awesome. Everybody enjoyed the trip. It was just kind of a dog training exercise. We got a chance to socialize our dogs. We got a chance to get them on and off a plane, have them around flight crew, see how they respond in the air, being in crates in the air, these kinds of things. So it was really just a training exercise, but it was to set the stage for our eventual Noah's Ark flight, where we were going to fly to either an actual trial or a mock trial in some other part of the U.S. Our training philosophy here at Redemption Row Canine starts with the health and wellness of the dog.
I believe all training programs should start first and foremost and have as a priority what's best for the dog. I know in the sport world and a lot of times in the protection world, sometimes we can put our agenda above the well-being of the dog. You know, we need you to down sit, stay, come, you know, stallion, search, transport. We need you to do that when we say do it. And for me, I start with health and wellness. After health and wellness, I go to nutrition. Nutrition is a big thing, and as a certified canine food formulator, I really, really, really am a stickler for great dog nutrition. We also have about 13 different supplements, goat's milk. We use all kinds of things here, electrolytes, and from health and wellness to nutrition, then comes engagement. And everyone who's ever worked with me will tell you that my thing is positive bonding with the dog. I'd like to believe, and if you look at the breed standards, all of my dogs fit well within the breed standards. I do prefer leaner dogs, but as you can see with the amount of space we have here and just the sheer amount of engagement, it's for their best. Like it's for their best interest. For instance, my Anatolian right now at 2 years old is 135. Some people might consider that underweight, but his growth plates just closed, you know, not too long ago. So for me to have put a bunch of weight on him would have potentially impacted his long-term development. And because the Anatolian's life expectancy is 12 to 14 years, I'm never in a rush with any of my dogs. So they are lean, but they're athletic. They're athletes. You know, we have elite canine athletes here. Extra weight on a dog, just it has so many consequences. So for me, my dogs on average are taking between 45 and 60,000 steps a day. Because I know that, I have Fitbits on them, I'm able to adjust their food to keep them at the weight that I believe to be desirable. And for a dog that is waking up in the morning, dragging a tire, then doing some sprints, hill sprints, then potentially some agility, they're gonna get their midday nutrition, and there'll be supplements added to that. We use red cell canine, we use goat's milk, Nupro, multivitamin. I mean, we have a ton of different things we use. I think a lot of times people can confuse proper nutrition with the amount, and a lot of people feel that if they feed their dogs more, their dogs are getting more. And we don't believe that here at Redemption Row Canine. On average, dogs are gonna digest about 20 to 30% worth of the nutrients in their kibble. So even with our kibble, we blend it down to a powder. We hydrate the kibble with their daily water requirements, and that's gonna raise the percentage of absorption to probably 50, 60% on kibble alone. So I would argue that despite being lean, my dogs are probably some of the healthiest dogs in the world right now. Redemption Row Canine, in a nutshell, is a group of people, a family of misfits who've come together under the premise of training dogs, learning about dogs, dog management, husbandry, canine learning theory. Everyone who comes here knows that they have a support system. We don't place any pressure on handlers or dogs. It's difficult in a world that can be very dogmatic. So we really challenge a lot of the dogmatic notions of what a dog's supposed to do and try to enhance what the dog already does. So if you have a dog that likes looking for you, then we're gonna try to utilize that in terms of searching. If we have a dog that drives on a ball, or a dog that loves biting things, you know, we're just gonna try to take that and enhance upon it. And if you just want a dog that loves you, that's gonna go to its bed when it's told, not go to the bathroom in the house, we specialize in that. So here it's all about the bond between the owner and the dog, doing what's best for the dog, and then enhancing what the dog already brings to the table. Happy dog, happy handlers.
I get to it first, I got you mad. I get sad when I get to it last. Get it, then I'm never going back. Get it, then I'm never going back. I get to it first, I got you mad. I get sad when I get to it last. Get it, then I'm never going back. Get it, then I'm never going back. Going up, going up, going up, going up, going up, going up. Get it, then I'm never going up, going up, going up, going up, going up.